I've kind of been accumulating reasons for coming to New Zealand.
We've got incredible diversity, in particular in Auckland, that rivals or exceeds that of places like New York or London. Innovation happens at the edges, and New Zealand literally geographically is at the edge of the earth, and yet it's really central, I think, to the kind of innovation that we need going forward.
There are specific learnings that we can glean from Maori culture about how to be in balance and wholeness and relationship with ourselves and with community.
We're not so interested in what you do, we're interested in who you are.
It's a great place to be able to test and try different products within a small constrained market.
When people don't seem to derive their self-worth from status and money quite so much.
In Silicon Valley, you oversell yourself. While here in New Zealand, of course, which I really love, is like people are so humble.
As investors, we're always looking for great companies that are somehow underappreciated. And I think New Zealand is an area that most venture capitalists have not been looking at. And so to me, that actually presents a unique opportunity to bring the mindset that we have for investing of really backing founders and their companies and letting them become, kind of live up to their full potential.
Innovation here is driven not just by a particular single industry agenda, not just by a particular political priority, but by really broad coalitions.
I have a very strong appreciation, I think, for communities that can align between government, the different institutions, as well as the people and the change makers.
We have done an extraordinary and continue to do a great variety of work, constantly learning new things to do, and being able to combine, not only in our work, but in our life, so many elements.
Our impact work doesn't create the kind of returns required for an entrepreneur visa. Do we have to trade our dream of living in New Zealand and get like jobs? Do we have to give up impact in order to live here?
I came to New Zealand about 4 years ago. And fell in love with the place immediately. I became a super keen mountaineer. What I came to realize quickly as well is that what an ability it has to be a global leader with climate change.
Giving legal personhood to bodies of nature is a transformational undertaking, and I would love to be in a place that's going to continue making that experiment and guiding others in that form of healing, that form of commons building.
When it came to my research, being a country that's so rooted in the environment, in culture, connecting with its people, and also its advocacy and leadership when it comes to environmental issues and also use of renewable energy sources.
What I've really, really appreciated is that there's been a strong commitment from the EHF team to be beyond tokenistic in embedding the Kaupapa Māori dimension into this program.
Kind of collaborative software and the open source collaborative software that's been coming out of Wellington for a while. I think it's had a huge influence globally and will continue to.
Amazing fellowship has presented itself. This global impact visa has presented itself. So it turns out we don't have to choose between impact and the security in which to build our venture. And this is a place I can thrive. And not only thrive, my work will thrive, and my work will also take root here in ways I can't begin to imagine.